Okay, this is integrating in spherical coordinates, and I am Jody DeVoe. Okay, so let's take a look at our first problem. We want to find the volume of a snow cone. So here's a picture of my snow cone. It's bounded on the bottom by a cone and bounded on the top by a sphere. Specifically, it's bounded on the top by a sphere with the equation x squared plus y squared plus z squared equals 16, and bounded on the bottom by the cone, z equals the square root of x squared plus y squared. There are certain equations that you should just know what they look like in 3D. The equation of a sphere is one of them. The equation of a cone is another one. A paraboloid, a cylinder. Those are all equations that you should know what they look like and be able to draw them in 3D. Okay, so this is a cone, and specifically it's a cone that is makes a 45 degree angle here between the z-axis and the xy plane. Okay, so we're going to do this in spherical coordinates. Okay, so I'm gonna line up my three integrals. I'm trying to find a volume. So that means that I'm just going to integrate one, but I need the whole rho squared sine phi to get my dv element in there. Okay, so all of this then makes up my dv. Okay, so now I'm going to talk about setting the limits here. Rho. Okay, so we're looking at our sphere here. And the sphere is what's bounded on the top, and it has a radius of 4. So that means I want to start here at the origin, and then I want to extend a line up so that it goes as high as 4. And think about that line of 4, distance 4, kind of coming down this way and down that way. Okay, so my rho is going between 0 and 4. Now phi. Phi is the angle that's measured from the positive z-axis down. So from the positive z-axis down, well, if it's 45 degrees up, that means it's got to be 45 degrees down to get that total of 90 degrees. We're not going to integrate in degrees, though. Remember, we need to integrate with radians. So phi, or sorry, rho is going to go from, rho goes from 0 to 4. Phi, our angle phi measured from the positive z-axis down, is going to go from 0 to pi over 4, or 45 degrees. And then theta. Well, I need to have this thing go all the way around the whole sphere, all the way around the whole cone, so I need theta to go from 0 to 2 pi. Okay, so again, the rho, the distance from the origin out to the surface, is going to go from 0 to 4. Phi, that's the angle that's measured from the positive z-axis down. If it goes 45 degrees up, it's got to come 45 degrees down, or pi over 4. So from 0 to pi over 4 gives me that phi angle. So this is my phi. This is rho. And then theta, I need theta to go all the way around the whole cone and all the way around that sphere. So that's going to go from 0 to 2 pi. And that's my theta angle. Okay. I'm not going to integrate that for you, actually. That's just a setup that I think is the hardest part of this. So that does it for our example.